you want to know how much time your learners are spending on each page or even completions on each page? Well, you can do that if you're working with CMI5 or xAPI out of the box with Storyline without having to add any type of custom trigger or anything like that. So let's dive into our project first of all, and notice that I have this project set up and it just has some simple pages, and I can go through and see how they are. So no custom triggers or anything like that. It's just kind of out of the box. Now what I've done is I've published this out to SCORM Cloud. SCORM Cloud is a test learning management system that you can get for free. I've been working with SCORM Cloud for over 12 years. It's been one of the most useful tools that I've ever worked with, and I'm still on the free account here. If you're just testing, it's great. If you wanted to expand it, then that's where you'd probably have to go into the paid version as well. So what I did is I uploaded this course right here. And in this course, when I take the course and I just went through the course itself, it starts to send over xAPI statements. Now, the important thing about the xAPI statements is the experienced and the left. When a learner goes to a page, it sends over an experienced xAPI statement. Now, an xAPI statement, if you don't know much about it at all, I have several videos that you could check out on those xAPI statements, or even how to build an xAPI statement as well. So check that out. The xAPI statement contains who the person is, which is right here, captured by the SCORM Cloud account. And then it sends over what action did they do? What verb did they do? And then you can describe that in any way that you want. However, Storyline just grabs kind of the page name. And so that's really what it does out of the box, is grabs the page name. You can change or add on additional custom statements if you wanted to, but again, we're just working out of the box. But under the left statement, this is gets sent over when they leave the page. But some important information gets sent over when they leave the page. And that is contained in the results section. xAPI is JSON data. JavaScript object notation, exact, something like that. So it's basically the ability to just format data. And this is really what it's sending over to the learning record store. The learning record store is collecting this data and you can make sense of it. But this is an important one to know because this is the amount of time. Now keep an eye on this, because right now it says PT 2.71s. It's 2 seconds, 0.71, and the S stands for seconds there. So that's the amount of time that I spent on this page. And then when it's sent over this left verb, it's there. So this is important, because when I have done this and implemented this in courses, it's been fascinating to me to see how long people are spending. And you could do this on average. You could drill down specifically to a user and see how much time. But just on average, to see how much time people are spending on it, because it could be like, do they find this relevant? Do they find this important? Is it not as relevant, or things like that? So that's why, honestly, I love to get this type of data, because I can also see the more popular pages. If people are if you're tracking per page, you can go, what pages are people going back to? When we implemented this for just kind of an open course that anyone could take, it was really fascinating to see that, you know, you would expect like the first page to be the most visited, but it wasn't. There was more pages in the middle that people were going back to that gave me an insight of like, okay, maybe that has more relevant information. Maybe we need to expand that out even greater. So that's the kind of information, I'm a geek, so I geek out about this kind of stuff. That's the kind of information that you can get out of xAPI if you build your reports or even know that the data is there. All right, so the data is there, and we in this course, I'm also sending it over to a learning record store. Now, I'm not sure if I have it here because I uploaded this course previously, but if I clicked on report to external learning record store, this is where I would connect to that learning record store. Now, the external learning record store that I'm using is Veracity. One thing I love about Veracity is out of the box, it gives me the full functionality of the learning record store. Other learning record stores, you can get like custom reports, but you can't really customize them. You can't really adjust them or anything. But with Veracity, you get the full functionality. You're still limited on the amount of data that gets sent over to the learning record store, But you could start out and create these full reports and then start worrying about cost once you, if you see that it's being accessed or used a lot. So that's just one recommendation that I would have, is get yourself an account with Veracity and you can start to create these reports. All right, so I've already set up this, and if I come into my analytics section here, in my analytics, this is where I can go in and see some of the out-of-the-box reports. So I can see actors with the most events, actors over time, how much, you know, how active are they in the system as well. So it does have a lot, but it does have the ability to create custom dashboards. So I'm going to click on custom dashboards, and I've already created one for this specific course. So here is my data. Now I've set up this report for usernames, and so I can see my top users, which they're all fake users here, but I can see the amount of completions, I can see the quiz score, I can see all this information that is typical with learning management systems. But this is where it starts to get more detailed. I can see average course duration. Now that probably is a learning management system as well, but coming here, I can start to see my pages visited. This is what I was talking about before. You could go in and see exactly what type of page or what's the most popular pages inside of your course. I'm not going to explore that one for now, but I could also do like most used has been experienced and left. But this is really what I'm trying to get down to. How much average time are people spending in these different pages? Now, these page names actually come from Storyline. It is important to name your pages to something that makes sense, and you could, that would make sense, especially in reporting. So if I come back into Storyline, name these pages right here, full, half, introduction. This is a sample course, but name your pages so when you actually are looking at these reports, it makes more sense to you. This is the beauty about it, is if I click on edit here, I then click on edit here. Now these are different widgets. So I can come in and add a widget, and you can add different types of widgets. You can add a number widget, you can add a graph, a bar, a pie chart, whatever you wanted to. They have a lot of capability there. But if I click on this edit right here, I see my raw data, which I can get into the raw data and see that specifically, but I can see what the graph is going to look like. So as I start to make modifications, it will update here. Now, I'm going to go into this because this is where I choose what type of chart that I want. But if I go into this new series, this is really where it comes down to. Now, the reason why it says new series is because I really haven't given it a title. I'd probably want to give it some type of title of like average time or something. It doesn't really show up here, so I haven't worried about it as much. But right here, make a column for each unique, and then I have to go in and identify what unique things do I want there to be a column, which I did right here. I went to the object definition name and then UND, which is the ID for that. So for each unique UND, I'm going to create a column. So each page name is going to have its own column. And now all you do when you create this is actually, if I exit out of this, it's just a simple drop-down box. And so I don't need to remember that. The object is the activity. You're trying to look for this data and where the data is. And this data, if I go back to StormCloud, is actually stored, or the name, ID, which is stored inside of this context. So that's the object itself. All right, so I'm coming back into here. I'm grabbing the ID. And then from data source, the statements, we're gonna set an average. You can do this as total, you can do this as a sum, but I wanna get an average time spent. If I wanna see the full amount of time, how much time everyone has spent on that page, I could do a sum instead. All right, then I'm gonna come in here, and this is a little bit different. If you'll notice back in StormCloud, this is what, where it gave me the PT. And it doesn't really make that much sense. And so what Veracity does for you is it converts it over to what actually makes sense and what you can create a report to. But it places it inside of a category called meta. And there's other things that it kind of converts, so it's good to become familiar with this. And Veracity is such a great company that they will walk you through this kind of thing when you sign up and work with you on that. But right here, I'm looking for the duration. I want to have values of duration, and it's going to have a count of descending, or I can have ascending if I wanted to. and then how many columns to show. This report can be very extensive if I wanted to go beyond 15 or if I wanted to go 5. It also depends on the amount of room that you have inside of your reports, so keep that in mind. And then I can start to filter this out as well. Now the filter is basically, I want to grab this parent ID. So the parent ID comes into play right here. So this parent ID is going to be, might look a little bit different once it gets into SCORM Cloud. So I may want to look at that data inside of SCORM Cloud, and that's where I grab that ID. So that's really all that I changed in order to get this here. Now you may have to change like the data settings to 0.001 to really have it be seconds as well if you wanted to. So check that out. If you're not getting exactly the numbers that you want, try changing that in the data settings. But this gives me data that I can then share out with stakeholders. In fact, if I come back in here, I'm going to hit cancel. What I can do is I can actually click on this icon and click on get link. Now, if I click on get link here, it's going to, and I could set some parameters there, but now I can go ahead and click on this link, and this link is shareable to stakeholders. This is the power of a learning record store. Yes, you could sign up for a free one with like SCORM Cloud or even just Keep Veracity, but making sense of the data is really where a learning record store comes into play. And now you could go ahead and create these types of reports, share them out with stakeholders so they know exactly how effective this learning is, how much time people are spending on it, what the quiz data looks like, and so forth. So hopefully this has been helpful for you. If you want to check out more, head on over to my website at learningdojo.ninja, and you could check out all my previous blog posts. You can download templates and then check out full courses, everything from A to Z in Articulate, Storyline 360, or xAPI Fundamentals. If you really want to dive in, you could check out the full course there. And if you like this video, head on over to my YouTube channel, click the like button and subscribe to my channel, as well as hit the bell notification so you get notified of all future videos as they come out. That really helps the algorithm, allows me to continue to create these videos for you so you get the most out of these different learning development tools. And really, my goal is to help you as much as possible with your job so you can improve your job and get the most out of your learning systems. If you have any other feedback, or if you actually just have other videos that you want me to produce, make a comment down below on my YouTube channel. I check out all the comments every week. And so you could say, hey, Jeff, I want to do this. I want to do that. I'm happy to hear that feedback as well. But that's all I have for today. So thanks, everyone. And I'll see you next time.